Squares.
And so J.J. Abrams' next movie that he will be producing will be a World War II supernatural thriller called Overlord. Now, it's supposed to take place the night before D-Day, and it follows a group of paratroopers who are dropped behind enemy lines to go destroy a radio tower. And then when they get there, things are bigger than they seem. So this is, they haven't quite told us
literally bigger. Like they've been shrunk, haven't they?
Yes, it's Honey, I Shrunk the World War II paratrooper. That is what they're doing. But no.
Tied, so you weren't expecting.
They haven't gotten into what the supernatural aspect of what this will be. But it is a J.J. Abrams movie. So I'm guessing aliens. If we want to look at his past movies that he's done, like Star Wars, you know, there's aliens in that. Star Trek, lots of aliens in that. We have Cloverfield, there was aliens in that. Then Super 8. Aliens in that as well. So, and I believe Lost is another one he produced, and I believe there was some sort of alien connection in that, if I'm correct. I never watched it, really, but, you know. So, I'm going to guess aliens.
I'm guessing aliens, too. Yeah. And that makes a lot of sense, too, with the World War II. This wouldn't be an original theme, either, because, what, History Channel's been doing the, like, World War II aliens, UFOs for a while now.
Oh, yeah, that too. But I could also see it going another direction. Now, the Nazis were linked with a lot of occult. You know, they had their own mythos. They developed their own legends and stuff like that. And they did, like, it's a fact that Hitler wanted the Spear of Destiny. Or, you know, he went after all these occult relics. And I'm not saying that the Spear of Destiny is necessarily an occult relic. It's just, you know, it's
supernatural related. Supernatural.
Yeah.
Relics.
Items. Yes, exactly.
Relics so, thought to have special power.
Special powers. There you go. So it wouldn't be too much of a stretch to see them go, you know, Nazi occult supernatural, other or aliens. Anyway you slice it, I have a feeling that the Nazis will be working with aliens or ghosts.
Or Egyptians who have the Stargate.
And then maybe we have a crossover series. Yes. Hmm.
We'll have ancient Egyptians giving, or them Nazis stealing ancient Egyptian technology to get the Stargate to bring the alien forces to Earth.
Yes, okay.
Who happen to be vampires. That's
probably, and they are, yeah, they're Egyptian alien Stargate vampires.
Yes.
That's what they'll be called.
Vampires are actually aliens. Got it.
Understood. All right, so we're right there.
Which, by the way, I will say for everyone's benefit, I actually hope that there's not vampires. I hope the twist is not that this is going to be a bunch of vampires, like a village of vampires. Because
that would be a horrible twist.
Yeah.
That would be an absolutely horrible, horrible twist.
I'm not interested in a vampire movie right now, especially not a Nazi vampire movie.
We've had plenty of vampire movies to recent date. You know, we had the Twilight stuff, which was
kind
not
of vampires.
Good. We had Abraham Lincoln, the Vampire Hunter.
See, we already had a historical vampire movie, a historical fiction vampire movie.
True.
Although, I'll have to say, you know, it wasn't really that historically accurate.
No, Brendan, no. The vampires totally controlled the South during the Civil War. What are you talking about? And Abraham Lincoln, that axe wasn't for chopping trees. That was for putting holy water on and fighting vampires.
Yes.
Exactly. Exactly. But there is speculation that this will be part of the shared Cloverfield universe. So it's speculation, granted. It's not, you know, a given. But considering J.J. Abrams' past, when he did Cloverfield, he tried to keep that monster the secret that it was an alien for the longest time. And he did a good job doing that. And then when they did the sequel, 10 Cloverfield Lane, which, yes, it shared the same name, but they didn't really say how it was connected until the very, very end. And they kept that a really good secret. Wouldn't surprise me too much that, yes, we're going to get aliens and it's going to be connected to the Cloverfield universe somehow. Anyway, it goes. It has piqued my interest because I love these type of historical set pieces. And World War II is the last time you can look at what America has fought, like a battles or a war America's fought, and clearly say, yes, we were the good guys in this conflict, rather than the Nazi Germans, who were obviously the bad guys. Every other conflict since then, it's been gray area. It's a lot of gray area.
It's very controversial. that there's especially opinions on both sides of all
of this. And I mean, since the Vietnam War, I mean, even the Korean War, Vietnam War, the first invasion of Iraq, the second Afghanistan, Iraq, there's controversy surrounding all of those. No matter what side of the fence you fall with those, you know that they there's controversy. So that's why I like going back to the World War II motif, just because you get that clear-cut good guy, clear-cut bad guy, and you know how I love villains. The Nazis are some of the best villains that have ever been, and unfortunately, they're kind of like real-life villains, but yeah. But that's what we think about it. Tell us what you think. Are you hoping for a Nazi ghost supernatural, like, weird movie, or just like aliens? I guess aliens are supernatural too. But tell us which way you think this is going to go. Hit us up. Comments down below, of course, at Where's My Face on Twitter and Google Plus on Facebook. Always good ways of getting a hold of us. But let's keep on a roll.